firing of the concentration camp. Sons and daughters of the railroad builder leave their stamp on America. We are the children of the Chinese waiter, born and raised in the laundry room. We are the offspring of the...
So my name is Nobuko Miyamoto. I call myself a community artist. I write songs, I choreograph, I create theater pieces, and mainly I'm stationed here in Los Angeles. Well, I think we've performed there several times. Chris and I'm from Los Angeles, but at that time I was living in New York. So for us to come out and be in a community setting, and actually that neighborhood was a place that my family moved to after the war, after we came out of camp. So it had a lot of significance for me. And that the fact that it was not just a storefront that was for Asians, but for Asian Americans and African Americans and whoever, third world storefront, sort of went along with my life, which at that time, I was heading in that direction of having a black child, and, you know, my world was sort of more cross-cultural in lots of ways. So the storefront, which my brother was part of, Warren was part of course, he was one of the big leaders of the storefront. We started coming out and doing, some of them were fundraisers, and then some of them were actual projects. We created a musical there that Peaches Moore performed in, and we took it into a Chino prison. So there was a lot of drugs in the community. People were dealing with young people who had drug problems, and Asian Americans were in jail because of drugs. So that was an issue that we created a work around. That was the first time we really wrote a musical and had people like Victor Shibata and Peaches and myself, and we all had played characters. You have to understand, when you come from living in New York, which is, there isn't really for Japanese Americans a geographic community. So for us to be in an actual community setting was a big deal and very stimulating. And that really was what drew me to move back to Los Angeles. I said, if I'm going to be in the struggle for the long run, I want to be in a community. And so that sort of drew me back. What did it mean to create music like this for people who had none? We had no voice, literally. Yes, there were Japanese singers and there was Japanese culture, and certainly people had music in their lives. But these songs were written from our experiences here. These were political songs. Now we call them freedom songs. Los Angeles, somebody took me to Senshin Buddhist Temple. Well, that's there. Anyway, I was in a sort of personal quandary because I was pregnant and I'm going to have a black child. There was a lot of turmoil for me about, was I going to be accepted in the community? And Reverend Moss was really my, Reverend Kodani was really my champion. He just assured me that everything was going to be okay. And so gave me the courage to be a single mother. And but he also gave me the keys to the temple to teach dance. He says, here, you can teach dance here if you want to, if you would like to. Creating a work for the stage gave people a complete picture, and people were drawn to it. People were excited about it because you could see Chinatown. You could see people who were people like them on the stage, that you could see their culture and their stories starting to bloom on the stage. It became a bigger idea. And we also saw that change was not going to come from the in the outside world. How do we change how we look at ourselves? How do we tell our stories? How do we grow a sense of our belonging in the United States if we don't have our own culture? Not just the culture that came, that we brought over with us, but the culture that is, came, that we that grew out of what our experience was. And so like Ghidra and all of these things, people in BC, we were doing it through music and dance and theater, and seeing that it was an important way of changing how we looked at ourselves and how people will look at us. I think we have to dig in deeper. I think it has aroused people. We are woke. A lot of people, more people are out on the streets and inflamed to do something. And I think it's a good moment, actually. It's made our contradictions much clearer. And, you know, making our community stronger and how art can help to do that. I'm convinced that it's a very, very still a very powerful way. People need to march and do those kind of things, but we need projects, we need communication, we need our own kind of propaganda and cultural depth to unite people with. People have to be grounded in who they are and feel comfortable with collaborating within across cultures. I think it's really important now because they're using us against each other. So we looked at ourselves in a different way. We weren't Orientals, as they had called us. We were Asian Americans. We were building our own community, our own sense of ourselves. We were looking at ourselves as something beautiful, something loving, something to be proud of. I knew there was something about me today. I knew there was something about me today. I walked home and look at all things in a different way. I knew there was something different about me today. About me today.